increase that trouble me. Many are they that rise up against me. Many there'll be which say of my soul, there's no help for him in God. But thou, O Lord, are a shield for me, my glory and the lifter of my head. And now my soul sings, great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised.
Amen, amen. Welcome, my listeners, to Thursday night on the best gospel, the best praise talk show in America, the TMA radio broadcast. And we are just getting ready to go into the broadcast, and we give God the glory. Great is the Lord, great is his name. He's worthy to be praised. In just a few minutes, we're going to bring on our special guest for this evening for a small interview tonight. So won't you just stay tuned? We got more music, we have weather coming up, and a little bit of something else. So stay tuned, and we'll be right back. Is the Lord greatly to be praised. Amen. Welcome, my listeners, to another episode Thursday night of the TMA radio broadcast. I'm your host, Pastor Akrogen. Tonight we have with us Apostle Michael Branch. He's pastor and overseer of Cutting Word Ministries, Long Island, New York. Amen. Welcome to the broadcast tonight, Apostle. Amen.
Just take it as a privilege and an honor to be associated with a great man of God. You and your wife, we're just so pleased to be a part of the kingdom of God and working with people that don't mind getting their hands dirty, doing the work of the Lord. Amen.
Amen. You're so right. It's good. It's easy to walk around with a title, but I tell you right now, if you don't get your hands dirty every once in a while, it profits you nothing.
Amen.
Amen. Listen, I just wanted to first again thank you for taking the time out your busy schedule for this small interview tonight. And with that said, Apostle, September is approaching, and with all the chaos in America, among the many other things that people are facing, what makes revival important to the believer?
Right now, I believe even with our current situations with the events that are going on in Texas and Louisiana with the storms, the flooding, had that not even taken place, I think we have lost focus of what has been right in front of our eyes so long. We've lost focus with the cross.
Yes.
And revival is what's needed to bring us back into the presence of the Lord.
Yes.
We've gotten so far away from God that it seems as though even when we pray, there's no change, no effect. When we are in our worship state, there's still no change, no effect. It is because we have withdrawn from God. God has not left us. We left the Lord. And as we look around, though, each and every day, as we look around this world, through our government, through our social activity, through social media, we can see just how disconnected we have come from God. So revival means we need to get back to a place where God allows us into his presence. God allows us to come back and commune with him and bring him the best worship and that we can possibly bring him without any residue. We need to come to God pure. We need to come to him holy, just like he said. As he is holy, we need to be holy. We need to go back and be rewashed all over again. The Bible said to be put back on the potter's wheel. What
yes.
does the Lord have to do to reshape and to remold us through the revival?
Yes.
We need to welcome.
Amen, amen. I tell you, that's what makes him revival so important, my listeners. Because is that we are at a time now we need to be revived, and it needs to start within us. Amen. Apostle, I did want you to share first a little bit about yourself to our listeners, and then we'll continue to go on.
Amen. Bringing this revival back to the city of Lewisburg is important to me because now, almost 30 years ago, it was prophesied to me and that I would come back into my homeland and begin to preach the word of God, and I would even be an instrument of getting some of the same people that I ran the road with and did my mischief, did my worldly things with, and help bring them to Christ.
Yes.
So, me being a native of Franklin County, born and raised right outside of the city limits of Lewisburg, out in the Ingleside community, it is important to me, and it is important to our ministry, it's important to my whole entire family, that we come back and give back to our roots. I'm a firm believer that we need to come together as a family and as a community to enact change. And what greater place to enact change than the place where you were born and raised? Brought up in the school system down at Paris, down in Centerville, came up through middle school in Gold Sand middle school, and then come through Lewisburg High School. Amen. And I spent the majority of my early life right there in Lewisburg. Worked for a local company, the Griffin Ford, right in Lewisburg. Amen. So I know that the struggles that goes on in the county. I know the burden that the people carry, lack of jobs, lack of opportunities. So we need to not only get back into the presence of the Lord to be for the spiritual things, but we need to get back into the presence of the Lord for the natural things as well.
Yes.
And so me just being a native of Franklin County, Franklin County is a place where everybody tends to know everybody, and I just want to come back and do whatever the Lord is leading me and our ministry to do to help bring awareness to the things that are going on in the county, things that are keeping us impoverished, keeping us shackled, keeping us, you know, from reaching the destinies that the Lord has for us. And I claim nothing great for myself, even with
the titles that I have. I'm not title streaking. I'm not title starving. I just come with a humble heart to say that I was a sinner saved by the grace of God. I don't even believe in a Bible. I have a Bible and never use it because my Bible is simple as this. I was a sinner saved by the grace of God. And I want to do whatever I can do to try to win as many souls to Christ as I possibly can.
Yes. Amen. Amen. And you hit it on the head. We are at a time where we are struggling. Where there's many poor around us. There's many lack of jobs. And people are really hurting. And now that we know that Cutting Word Ministries are bringing revival to North Carolina, can you tell our radio listeners a little bit more about this revival that's coming up?
Yes, sir. This revival, I wanted to theme it the church that Christ died for. The reason why I came up with that theme is because if we take a look back or if we mirror ourselves, could we ask and honestly answer the question, is this the church that Christ died for? If my lifestyle is the things that I do on a daily basis, giving God or giving Christ a honest representation of why he died for us. And so with this revival, we hope to just bring souls to Christ. We don't come in any shape, form, or fashion. We don't come in the old tradition of having so much program. We come just to get into the presence of the Lord. We want to bring worship.
Yes.
And worship ushers us into the presence of God. And as we begin to get closer to God, God then will reveal the things that we need to do. So we don't need to come so programmed. We don't need to come so outfitted. We just need to come and be in the presence of the Lord. Amen. We talk a lot about carrying the Spirit of the Lord with us. If you carry the Spirit of God with you, then church would be easy.
Yes, it will.
We have gotten stuck in tradition. We've gotten stuck in doing the things that we used to do of old, and because of ignorance, a lot of things of old was done that wasn't even pleasing to God, but it was done on a regular basis. People took it for fact. When in absolute, it was against the Word of God. We just try to bring a different perspective. We want to bring the Word of God and make it plain and simple. I like to always bring out this point. The Word of God is not hard. It's not hard to understand. And I want a lot of people, I want your radio listeners to understand this tonight. The Word of God is not hard to understand. I have a lot of people come to me and say, you know, I try to read the Bible, but it's so hard to understand. I want you to think on this thought. Why would a God that loves us so much that he gave his only begotten Son to ransom us, then get sent a word that we wouldn't be able to understand? That don't make no sense. God don't work in confusion. God's word is easy to understand. And let me give you the clue as to how to understand. You first must go on your knees and seek God in prayer. And the closer you draw to him in prayer, the more you get to him in your worship, the clearer the word is and the easier it is to understand the word. But this is just a part of a process of us getting closer to God, that we understand his ways and his thoughts, his character, the way that he wants us to be, the way he wants us to live. And then we can affect change.
Yes, amen.
And this is what our revival wants us. This is the outcome of what we want our revival to be.
Amen. Amen, Apostle. I have heard that same phrase, that the word is so hard to understand, but if we have a connection with the Holy Spirit will show us, it'll teach us exactly what the scriptures is saying.
Yeah.
And the reason that people find it hard is because they have no relationship and they're not hearing the Spirit. They can't hear the Spirit because of their relationship is not there. That's the whole difference of it. You said it so plainly. Amen. And I just thank God, Apostle, for this revival coming up, because it's definitely, as we see people continue to have sickness in their bodies, family members sick, and not only that, but people losing their job. We see now hatred and racism rising up more. It's never been a way but now it's more so now open and blunt. This revival is needed. You know, kids are going back into the school now, and they need to understand that the relationship with God is the difference, even in their little journey.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Again, so while we're here, can you tell our listeners the dates and any other information you want to share about this revival?
Yes, sir. First and foremost, certainly we thank God for His Spirit. We thank God for the leading of what is taking place. We have this motto, my wife and I, that as long as we got Christ out front and we follow Him, everything will work out. And we not only take that as something that we follow in ministry, but as we follow in our natural life as well. I want to thank God for the man of God that is allowing us, or is letting us use his facility down at Free Salvation Holiness Church. You know, we're just so grateful for the pastor there for opening his doors, for letting us bring this revival in. And likewise, we're grateful to you and your wife for being advocates for us as we come back and forth into the state of North Carolina. Certainly on September the 20th, the 21st, the 22nd, and the 23rd, it'll be four-night revival. We don't want to be like times of old when you have the first night of the revival, people just trickle in and it didn't get good until the end of the week. No, we want to start the revival off power. We want as many people that as will come out that Wednesday night. Come in a worship mode. Come in. Don't worry about how you dress. Don't worry about who's sitting beside you, in front of you, or behind you. But come in with a mindset to worship God and to be faithful. And on September the 20th through the 23rd, it's only just a couple of weeks away. It's being hosted at Free Salvation Holiness Church right on Fox Park Road, right there in the city of Lewisburg. For those of you on the sound of my voice that may know me, I'm sure a lot of people know of me around Franklin County, know of my family, the Branch family. We want you to come out and partake in what the Lord has for us. Listen, we understand that you are members of other churches. We are not trying to steal members. Glory be to God. That's something that I can deal with all together on a different platform. But we, as the body of Christ, supposed to fellowship one with another.
Amen.
So we want you to come out. If you don't have nothing to do at your church on those nights, come out and fellowship with us so that we can get into the presence of the Lord together. There might be something said or done that you can take back to your ministry that will open the doors wide open for the Holy Spirit to come in and dwell in your house. Amen. So we just invite one and all.
Amen.
Male, female, black, white, Hispanic. Amen. The young, the old, the sick, and the afflicted. Amen. The those that are wealthy, those that are poor. We want everybody to come. Amen. So that we can go into the presence of the Lord together. So our lives can be changed. So that we don't have to live in this constant stigma of being oppressed and depressed all the time. But yet we can live the abundant life that Christ has ordained for us. So again, September the 20th through the 23rd. That's a Wednesday night through a Saturday night. Amen. Only a couple of weeks away. Right there on Fox Park Road at Free Salvation Holiness Church. We look so forward to seeing you here. We want the services to start about 7:30 each and every night. We want to be a blessing to those that come. Amen. And listen, while I have your attention, we are going to be set up pretty well in that if there are any musicians, amen, that want to use your talent, want to use the gift that God has given you to help play some instruments during this revival. We have the instruments if you just want to use your time and your gift to play. If there are some singers out there that just want to help with praise and worship, if you got a group or you got a choir, you want to come in and share what the Lord has put in your spirit by way of songs of Zion, please come out. Amen. We're giving you the formal invitation right now. If you show up, you can sing. If you show up, you can speak. We're not a stuck-up ministry. We're a ministry that just
open it up for the people of God to be able to share what God has on the inside of them, what he has blessed them with, how he has gifted them. So come out, share your talents with us, whether you play an instrument, whether you sing, whether you can pray, whether you want to help usher, whatever it is that you do well in the house of God, we want you to be free, amen, to come in and fellowship with us during this revival.
Amen. Amen. Again, brothers and sisters, you've heard it. If you're in the local area, do share this on your Facebook page. Share this broadcast, because you never know how this will impact somebody's life, your neighbor's life, your children's life. You know, we are looking to impact the city of Lewisburg with the word of God. So each night, amen, there will be something for you to receive. And if you have a talent, come on and show us the blessing that God has given you. Some can sing, some can play. Amen. Amen. And we're just looking for just a high time in the Lord that we be revived, that we can continue. Because the enemy is, he's going to stay on the attack, so we need to stay on the attack too. Amen. Amen. Apostle, do you have anything before we finish this interview that you would like to address to the listeners at this time?
Amen. First, again, I just thank God for your programming that is reaching the people in the county. I would just encourage those that are listening to keep listening to this broadcast. This man of God is on the battlefield for the Lord. He's trying to find ways to use different strategies to be able to get the word of God out and to reach the community, not just by way of the Bible. I listen to this program, how they are reaching out, getting out, doing interviews in the street, trying to bring the city together. So I encourage the people to continue to support this broadcast, support this ministry, because here's a ministry that is reaching out to the people, reaching out to the souls, trying to bring as many people into the house of faith as possible. I will say this in my closing, and I thank you for having me on for tonight. I'm just so grateful for what the Lord is doing through you and your wife there, two humble servants right in the city of Lewisburg that are extending their hands to each and every body to be able to further the kingdom of God, further the gospel, and continue to walk in humility. That is a lost commodity in the body of Christ right now, humility. So I thank God for you. I thank God for what he's doing. I want to say in my closing to the people that are listening on tonight, God is for real. And God wants to do some phenomenal things in your life. But we as the people have withdrawn so far from God that it seems that when we're praying and when we're worshiping, God is not listening. But I'm here to tell you, God hears all and he sees all, and he can. But God just wants us to humble ourselves and begin to pray.
Amen.
Turn from our wicked way. He said, then will I forgive your sins and I will heal your land. Listen, as the scripture even says, he said, I will heal your land. If you open your eyes, you will begin to see that the land where your feet tread upon,
come on, come on,
is even sick. The land is diseased. The land is not even healthy anymore. But God wants to bring us to a place,
yes,
where not only the land will produce, but we'll be a product of the land. Why? Because his spirit will be in the earth. And as his spirit is in the earth, his spirit now will be in man. We need to draw nigh to God. Forget about shape, form, or fashion. Forget about all the things that are hindering us, that are building walls or building partitions between us and God. He said, let nothing separate us from him.
Yes.
And let us begin to worship God with a pure heart, a clean conscience, and a clear mind. Don't worry about, hallelujah, what somebody else is doing. The William brother had a song, said, sweep around your own front door before you try to sweep around mine. Clean up your house. Clean up your space. Get yourself right. Get the mold out of your eye before you try to tend to somebody else.
Come on.
Here's how we have to come back to God.
My God.
As we begin to come back to God, God will begin, hallelujah, to manifest his glory in our life. I am a believer.
Yes.
I'm a true born believer. I'm a man of faith.
Yes.
I believe in faith.
Without faith, you can't please God.
Amen.
And I dare you to start walking in faith. Walk in faith and stop seeing what you can't do and what you ain't going to do and start saying what I can do. And it is possible through Christ who strengthens us.
Yes.
Come out and fellowship with us on September the 20th through the 23rd. Right there, free salvation holding the church. And let us come and fellowship together. Let's be on one accord, one body, one mind, one spirit, serving one God.
Yes.
And I believe we can change things. It only takes just a handful. The Lord said, where two or three are touching together, I touch them and agree, He would be in the midst.
Yes.
Amen. Come on out and let's touch and agree. And let's worship in the spirit of a living God. And I believe God will change our lives. You make a difference. You make a difference.
Amen.
Never allow yourself to think that you don't make a difference. Yes, you all by yourself make a difference. You can effect change if the Holy Spirit is working through you.
Mm.
Amen. And bring the Spirit of God on with you and fellowship with you. Thank you so much, Pastor Nino, for having me on tonight. Thanks to your wife as well. Thanks to this program. And we just encourage the people of God to continue to listen, to continue to support this ministry. And to come out and fellowship with us. Amen. You can contact Pastor Nino here for any other pertinent information that we're going to need. We're going to have some guest summons there during the week. Praise God, we're going to have some people there that really know how to pray, because it's a revival. But revival ain't all about preaching. Revival is whatever it takes to get into the presence of God.
Yes.
So we want to come, just come. Bring those that are sick, bring your children. Like the preacher said, that the school is open now. We need to pray for our children going to school at a time like this right here.
Yes.
Start anointing your children before you send them off to school. Come, bring your all. Let us bless your all. Hallelujah. Let us bless your all the right way.
Yes.
So that your all will even have effect when you anoint your house and anoint your children.
Come on.
God bless y'all. Thank you for this time, Pastor.
Amen. I tell you, Pastor, we about to have revival right now. Amen. Thank you so much. I tell you, you just brought back old childhood memories when they didn't even have a pianist, when they just had that old wood floor, and you can hear people stomping on the floor, man, just praising God and getting into the presence. They don't have all the things we have now, the cordless microphones and the keyboards, and they would tear that floor up, and you would hear them clapping and hear them stomping. I tell you, that's something else right there. So I'm just excited. Again, listeners, the revival is at Free Salvation Holiness Church. That's 419 Fox Park Road, Lewisburg, North Carolina. And if you need to contact me, Pastor Akritz 2016 at gmail.com. Amen. Apostle Branch, thank you so much again for taking the time out to just share on this small interview about the revival coming up and about yourself as well.
Yes, sir. Pastor, if I could just add this a little bit. I want the people to know, when you give a program and the people don't show up, ask yourself why they don't show up. And then ask yourself, did you support them?
Mm.
It's another traditional thing that we do that is such a bad example of what the body of Christ should be.
Mm.
We're supposed to fellowship with one another. We're supposed to support one another. Not only when you have a program, you want everybody to come out and support you, but you have to get out and support other people's stuff as well.
Amen.
Just want to do that with you. God bless you, Pastor.
Amen. God bless you, Apostle.
You know, sometimes things can get really heavy. So I've invited some of my friends to help me out on this one. Mr. Terry Burge. Sakina Joseph. A City on the Hill, where y'all at? And little old me, Mr. TYWEBB. Corey, this is from you, baby sis. Your victory. It's now.
Sitting here in my room, tears flow from my face. Never in a million years things should be this way.
I can still hear his voice, hear our Father say,
till you cry becomes a raging sea. From this life you cannot hide. So come and take a walk with me, and we're gonna fight.
Amen, amen, hallelujah. Amen. We want to thank again our guest on tonight, Apostle Michael Branch of Cutting Word Ministries in Long Island, New York. Amen. You guys heard it. We don't have to go back over it. Amen. We've shared with you the importance of revival and also what the theme is, the church that Christ died for. Are we the church that Christ died for? Are we looking at the church, the believers? Amen. And you know, we hit on, we want to bring our worship in the presence of God. Amen. If we bring the Spirit of God, amen, if we bring the Spirit of God with us through the church will be easy. Church will be easy if we bring the Spirit of God with us. Amen. When we come out into the house of God. Amen. Bring the word. We talked about bringing the word plain and simple, making it plain, because I've been places where I sat in and because words, big words were used, I couldn't understand because I didn't know what some of those words mean. You know, some of those with doctorate, PhDs and different things of that sort, sometimes using words that we don't understand, and it's hard to understand. Amen. But we want to bring the word so plain that a child could understand. Amen. And that's what Jesus talked in parables to, a point where it made it easy. Amen. For the believer, the word is not here for us to not understand, but for us to understand what the word is saying. And we believe that, we know this by the relationship we have in the communion with the Holy Spirit, which gives us that wisdom and knowledge. Amen, amen. We thank God for tonight's broadcast. We thank God for this revival that's coming up September the 20th through the 23rd, 7:30 p.m. Nightly. And the address is 419 Fox Park Road, Lewisburg, North Carolina, at the Free Salvation Holiness Church. Pastor Tyrone Davis, amen, my childhood friend, classmate, amen. The humble brother, man. The brother is so humble, man. I tell you, this is what we should do. We should fellowship with each other. Amen. We got to do it. I've been a lot of places, and as Apostle said, you know, we shouldn't be so out of order, or we be so programmed to, we invite people to come to our events, our choir anniversaries, our services. People come in and worship services, and then you never are able to visit anybody else. We supposed to fellowship one with another. Amen, somebody. Amen. Let's go with your weather forecast tonight. A low of 70 degrees. Friday, thunderstorm and rain. High of 74 with a low of 68. Saturday, chance of rain and showers. High of 81 with a low of 65. Sunday, mostly clear skies. High of 85 with a low of 62. Monday, partly cloudy. High of 87 with a low of 67. Tuesday, mostly cloudy, high of 86 with a low of 72. And then Wednesday, chance of rain and thunderstorm, high of 81 degrees with a low of 59. And that's your 7-day forecast. Amen. I tell you right now, and continue to send our prayers out to Texas, the families, those that have lost everything they have. We're praying for those that lost loved ones. Amen. We're praying that God comfort them and supply their needs in the name of Jesus.
Not
amen.
A second or another minute, not an hour of another day, but at this moment when my arms outstretched, I need you lay away as you have done so many times before. Through a window or an open door, I stretch my hands to thee, come rescue me. I need you right away. I need you now. I need you now. I need you now. I need you now. Not a second or another minute, not an hour of another day, but Lord, I need you right away. If I never needed you before, to show up and restore all of the things that I let slip while I was yet searching the world for more, you're the truest friend I've had indeed. You're my best friend, I know indeed, 'cause I stretch my hands to thee. Come rescue me, I need you right away. The agony of being alone, fear of doing things on my own, tears and trials that come to me, me strong. Feelings of guilt, hurt, shame, and defeat, the way the trials that beat on me.
was my baby brother. I tell you, you know, y'all probably missed a couple years ago. I broadcast and I said how we used to sing together and things happened. And it would be so nice for us to be able to sing again together. We was harmony. God synchronized our voices. And I told y'all the story, you know, with him and I. And now I just remember that broadcast as I listened to his voice. God brought him right on back to his talent. God gives some of us the voice anointing to sing, amen, not only singing to God, but singing to the people, that through song, their spirit, amen, be blessed. And so that was my baby brother. He's doing some things right now. And I tell you, we had dinner. We hadn't had dinner in a long time. A few Sundays ago, my wife cooked a fantastic meal, and we invited him and his wife over, man. And, you know, because me and my brother was like white on rice, we was like a back pocket on a pair of blue jeans. Where you saw one, you seen the other. But, you know, over time, we didn't get to hang out as much and do much together anymore. We used to sing together all the time. Sometimes we used to sit in the backyard under the stars and harmonize, him and I. And we lost that, but we praying that now he's back into singing, amen, the praises of God. We hoping that one day, that once he finished doing the things that he's doing in the studio, hey, that we can get back and sing a couple of songs ourselves, because we didn't use music. Our voice was the music. Amen. So again, that was my baby brother. Amen. Singing, amen, I need you now. Amen. Also, Angela's Grill is located in Centerville, across from the Dollar General store. They're open 5 a.m. to 5 p.m. Monday through Thursday, and then Friday 7 a.m. to 9 p.m. If you want to know what's on the menu, you can call 919-339-8713. Again, that's 919-331-8713. Nino's Professional Barbershop. Come on, somebody say hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Man, I tell you, 217 South Main Street. I'm so excited I can't even holler get the address out. 217 South Main Street, Lewisburg, North Carolina. As I announced a few months ago, maybe a little bit more than a few months ago, that we're working hard to open it up very soon. Well, I got on the date. The dates should be around September the 15th or before. So glory be to God. Amen. We're still at the inspection stage. But we just thank and praise God that now is on the horizon. We see it like the sun coming up. Amen. We can see. Amen. We can see it. Glory be to God. Amen. I'm telling you right now, I didn't lose my mind. I didn't get impatient. I didn't get agitated. I didn't get mad. I just had to wait on the Lord. Amen. Because, you know, sometimes when we look at things and we have plans for things to happen, it might not go the way we think. And it ain't for us to get upset with it. It just, it ain't his time. And so when it get open, that's the time. Amen. Somebody, sometime we get stuff out. And I told him months ago that we were going to be opening up. I put it out on Facebook, created a new page. And we've had some things to come up. But you know what? God is faithful. Amen. And not only that, but I'm just so excited. I tell you right now, if I smile any harder, my jaws be jacked to the ceiling. Amen. God made provision for us to be, amen, back at the College Chapel, Lewisburg College Chapel. To God be the glory. Hallelujah, man. Amen. I tell you right now, what the devil meant for bad, amen, God turned it around for good. And I just believe that, because, you know, when we deal with folk and they say they're going to do a thing and they keep holding you up, hindering you, amen, and then this and that come about, amen. But, you know, again, patience, amen, and praying and believing. And I spoke that thing. I said, you know what, we're going to be there. Amen. But not only that, but glory be to God, we got people praying. People have been praying. Amen. Married couples, friends has been praying. Amen. That we get back to that location and look at what God has done. I got the call on this week. Glory be to God that everything was okay. It has been addressed to the staff. It has been told to the school's officials. Hey, man, that we'll be in there at 8:30. Hey, man, but we start at 8:45. I said, that's fine. I'll be there at 8:30 anyway. It doesn't matter what if the time he gave was a 15, 20 minutes off. I'm just glad and thankful that we are able to have that place again. Hey, man, look at God. Hey, man, and now the school is back. And we're going to be praying for the people that come in, and we're just going to be going, amen, which way the Spirit, amen, takes us. That's where we're going. Amen. My wife, Pastor Carl, and I, amen, going to love on the community. We're going to love on those students, amen, that may participate in or share in our worship service experience. We are just looking for God to move in a mighty way, and we just want to remain humble. Continue to have the love that we have to see people change. We want to see people deliver. We want to see their lives impacted by God. We don't want to see people down and out and feel like giving up, you know, feel like they just there's no more hope. We hate that. We hurt for that. But we want to see that on Monday, amen, you might came in looking this way, but by Friday, glory be to God, by Friday, good God Almighty, woo, thank you, Jesus. By Friday, we don't even know who you are. You look different. Your walk is different. Woo, your talk is different. Come on, somebody. That's what we want to see. Not saying, well, I know it ain't going to happen, but I believe it's going to happen for me. Come on, that's what we're talking about. That's what we're talking about. I believe it. Amen. So, again, we will have worship services each and every Sunday at Lewisburg College Chapel. Amen. That's 507 North Main Street, Lewisburg, North Carolina, located in the college campus of Lewisburg at 845. And I'm going to be updating the Healing Word Ministries Facebook page. And we're just going to be loving, amen, on those that come through those doors, amen, as everybody, amen. Even if you don't come through those doors, we still love you. We love people, and we thank God for people in our lives, people that we have in our circle that we can share with, talk with, and just be a help to us as we be a help to them, amen, because we are in this thing together. And the thing I just thought about just now is that when you succeed, come on, I succeed. Glory be to God. Amen. Get that into your spirit tonight, leaders. Amen. When you invest in your people, when your members, amen, are invested into, glory be to God. When they exceed, glory be to God, you exceed. Come on, I think we ought to talk about that. That's another topic for another day. Amen. I tell you, that just came to me. Amen. When the people, hallelujah, amen, when they exceed, when you invest in them and you building them up, amen, you doing that for them, guess what, you are climbing too. Hallelujah, glory be to God, man. Thank you, Jesus. So again, Nino's Professional Barbershop, the date September the 15th or before, amen, but that's the date, that's the last of the day that they're gonna have to inspect, but we're looking, maybe they're gonna call me on that week, amen, and say, hey, we coming by there, and I'll be there to unlock the doors and have them to come in and do their walkthrough inspection and let them say, hey, here's this grade, you read it. And I'm telling you, well, we're still looking for barbers. We reached out to some professional barbers. We reached out to some people. A lot of the people that has responded has been those students that are about to wrap up their schooling around November and December. But if anyone that's already working in the barber field, the hairstyle field, you can contact me at Akritz Professional Cuts, that's CUTZ, at gmail.com. And again, that email is Akritz, AKRIDGE, Professional Cuts, CUTZ, at gmail.com. Amen. So again, you can reach out to me if you are you got a family member that's looking for a professional atmosphere, because we're gonna go and have a professional atmosphere. We want to have a professional atmosphere. We want to have a family environment where your children can come in and they got going to hear all the cussing, the bad, foul language. You know, that's what this shop that I'm creating is about. And so I can't rule when someone else owns the shop. I can't make nobody. But when I own my own shop and pay the mortgage and pay the utilities, I can put out some barbershop rules. And we don't want to be talking about the midnight hour mess, the 800 number mess. Y'all know what I'm saying. We don't want to have none of those conversations in our chairs. We don't want to talk like that, and we don't want to entertain it. And we want to be able to, where a woman bring her child in, she's comfortable. Or, you know, a father can bring his son in, and they're comfortable. And so that's the atmosphere that we want, and all nationalities are welcome. And they can be comfortable. And so that's what we are driving to do, as we see that the city downtown is cleaning up its image. And we want to be in the mix as they continue to build, restore buildings, and bring in business. We don't have to act like the hood. We don't have to act like the world. We don't have to talk trash in society. Amen. You go out to the doctor's office. Can you imagine going to the doctor's office and you're sitting there with such filth and such in the atmosphere? You don't want to go there and sit there and wait for them to call your name. You don't do that. You know? You don't see it in the courthouse. You know, people go to courthouse for different things. But you don't see them talking all out. They get the man that's behind that with that gavel respect. He demands respect. If not, you're going to jail. But I ain't taking nobody to jail. I'm not going to write you off. I just want you to know that I'm going to respect you. And at the same token, we want you to respect the shop. We want to have values. And we want to have values so that we want to be able to give back to the community. We want to help. We want to do projects. We already got one organization that we are connected with. That's Guns Down, Knowledge Up. We've done our bid to help to do the little that we could do with giving back the free back to school haircuts for the less fortunate children out here, as they as an organization gave out free snacks and drinks and book bags and stuff so kids can be prepared. And not only that, I just read the post that Guns Down Knowledge Up is preparing to collect goods, canned goods and clothes to ship out to Texas. See, it's that's the stuff that I'm telling you that motivates me. Not somebody that want to run for office, and I don't see you working and doing nothing in the community. I don't see you getting these resources together to help anybody. I don't see you doing it, but you come around and say, hey, vote for me. It's easy for me to go around and say, you know what, we need jobs, we need a better community, we need to clean up this area. You know, we see a lot of drugs, we see a lot of bad things going on in this community, we need to clean it up, vote for me. That's easy. But I would like to see you working. The community people that live in that area want to see you working. It would be nice to see the town officials, and the county commissioners and the city council, have come together to do a back-to-school bash as a town of Lewisburg, and the whole block from that courthouse square all around blocked off, giving out book bags and school materials and hot dogs and chips and drinks. That would have been amazing. Now I can say, you know what, y'all are doing something to bring unity to the people. But we see those that have been kicked, those that have made some mistakes, those that has been affected by violence, say, you know what, we see the violence, my family member has gotten killed, I want to make a difference. So now you see these people that don't have the limelight, these people that are not on the ballot are doing stuff. And I commend this brother, Dorian, founder of Guns Down, Knowledge Up. Amen. And we, amen, welcomed them, amen, I invited them to the revival. The brother said he would be there. I'm still getting back word for someone to come out to represent Wednesday night, because I know that he works a job, and I think he's going to be there the weekend, the weekend night for revival. We want to just acknowledge the group and himself Because the ministry go beyond the four walls. The ministry goes beyond just our program at our church. It goes out to the neighborhood. It goes to connect with organizations such as this to make its community better. And I thank God for also NYB Outreach Ministry, Evangelist Connie Hespeth, for sponsoring us each and every other Tuesday at 1 o'clock, where I share a word of God. I also talk about some of these issues as well before I get into the message. But that is God. Amen. Connecting people with like minds and like hearts, desire for change, and to see people in the community build up. I just thank God for that. I thank God for the people that surrounded me now to do a work. Amen. Because it's more than going in there, taking up the offering and going in the back and counting it, making decisions at the round table, going into a meeting before the people and say, this is what we get ready to do for this quarter or that quarter throughout the year. This is what we paid out. This is what we received in, and go home. The fight still stands. It still go on. And we got to continue day by day, and we got to do it week by week and month by month and year by year. Glory be to God. I enjoyed, amen, Apostle again for coming on tonight. Let us continue to broadcast and listen. We'll be right back.
What do you want the Lord to say?
Just a little more. sun don't shine. After a while, the clouds will pass over. And we'll shout hallelujah after a while.
Been listening to Thursday night on the TMA radio broadcast. Hey man, we thank God for you listeners. Hey man, share this on your Facebook page, your Twitter page, your Instagram, wherever, and let somebody know we're here Sunday through Thursday between the hours of 7 p.m. and 8 p.m. On Wednesday night is midweek praise between the hours of 8 p.m. and 9 p.m. and then on Thursday between 8 p.m. and 9 p.m. each and every week We give God the glory. We will be broadcasting, amen, all of the things that's coming up shortly. So enjoy and share it on your page and let people know we're here each and every week. We thank God for you, and we want you to be safe. We want you to invite your friends, your neighbors, amen, your neighbors and everybody out to the revival that's coming up for the month of September, September the 20th through the 23rd, 7:30 p.m. The children are back in school. Amen. There are many families. I'm telling you, prayer changes things. And we're looking for you to come in and have a experience, amen, with God. Hallelujah, glory to God. We thank you again, my listeners. Tune in on Sunday night between the hours of 7 and 8 p.m. for the first night of the week. God bless you. Enjoy your weekend. Happy Labor Day. Be safe. Watch out for the gas grills. There's so many accidents out using that gas grill. Be careful. And enjoy your family. Enjoy your little vacation. Because many people are going to be off on Friday. Many people are going to be off on Monday. And they got that long weekend. So enjoy. Be safe. And watch out for your drivers out on the road. Amen. While you're driving. God bless you.
Find favor in your sight.